risk. How prominent is this debate now in FX?
It's kind of ebbed a bit, I would say, to be honest. I mean, where the traction comes is in the oil price and what it means for, you know, those emerging markets that were already struggling on the tapering US story, whether that be compounded then by the Syria story. But a number of those currencies seem to have stabilized, recovering a little bit. So the Syria traction for the currency market, at least, I think is dissipating, as you can see, even in terms of headlines, it seems to be dissipating.
I want to talk specifically about the yen. Still seems very much on the defensive after this 2020
yeah.
win.
Yeah.
More evidence, though, that Abenomics is working. What do you make of the yen now?
I'm slightly surprised it hasn't done more. I thought dollar yen would have been through the 100 and onwards because, you know, we've had a nice kind of cocktail over the weekend. As you say, the Olympics win, upward revision to Q2 GDP. But just everything above 100, you know, I don't know, the air gets thin up there and people kind of say enough is enough. I mean, our own forecast is the year end is 99, so we're quite happy that it fails every time. But I was a little surprised. I thought I'd come in this morning and see dollar yen through 100. So maybe there's just exhaustion creeping in there.
Just generally, in terms of the dollar, on the back of payrolls, on the tapering debate. Actually, let me ask you first, is the tapering plan still on track, would you say?
It's looking slightly more dubious, isn't it? I think most people felt that September was nailed on, was only a question of amount. Now we're coming to next week's FOMC meeting, and we're debating will they or won't they? And, you know, I think payrolls has done that.
Do you still buy the dollar on the dips, though?
Yeah, I still think you buy the dollar. I mean, ultimately, they're going to taper. Ultimately, they are moving towards the exit, whereas the ECB and the Bank of England, at least in terms of what they're talking, are saying, look, frankly, if anything, there's pressure for potential additional easing. The US are not saying that.
Europe, the mess that is Italy, the Senate panel meets to consider expelling Berlusconi from the Senate. The implications are huge here. How worried is the market by this?
The implications are huge for Italy,
political. Well,
yeah, I would have said that 8 months ago, but, you know, we've had the Italian elections and we had all the wobbles, will they be able to form a government and all that kind of carry on. And to be honest, although there was a temporary wobble in the bond market, it was temporary and the implications for Euro were very fleeting as well. And I think this time around, because you've got OMT in the background, I think there's much more confidence that Italy's kind of tribulations will be confined to Italy and that it won't create a new problem. Germany, I think, much bigger focus on the political side for the euro than Italy.
Where's euro dollar at the end of the year?
I think much lower. I think sub 130. I mean, our forecast is 125. And we seem to be heading in that direction. I'm still comfortable, as I say, with buying this dollar on any dips, and that includes against the euro.